Today, we're going to talk about AI hype. This is just the idea that AI is the most important thing we can pay attention to. And we see news increasingly focused around AI and the importance of AI and how AI is changing everything. Amazing art tools turning images into video that look stunning. We see the tooling that allows us to take these amazing AI models and run them on our own computers, and new models come out constantly. There are amazing developer applications where you can take these AI models and have them work for you to be able to organize and understand the code that you write. And on top of this, social media is flooded with these messages that AI is changing almost everything. There was a message here talking about how AI is even changing college administrations. And this thought that AI is changing everything is amazingly evocative. It makes you immediately think and feel that there's this impending thing, this danger, this threat, this warning that you need to be looking out for. But the reality of AI and where it actually fits is very different. So this model represents how I think about AI. It isn't terribly accurate, but I think it gets this point across of like where AI capabilities are today. You have this sort of green space, which is like AI capability, right? There's this kind of core in the middle. And then you got this like larger circle of all of the possibilities of what AI can do. And in that, you've got these kind of points. I think the biggest one that we were really surprised by was generative art and media. Generative coding, similarly. Thinking back on how we thought about computers, we thought that the creative aspects of the work is going to be this really hard to do thing. It's not. And you have self-driving cars, you've got translation, you've got like video editing. Videos edit themselves now, practically. I use AI for video editing. They can win esports games. You've seen it win Go, you've seen it win games of League of Legends. It gives you amazing feedback on your writing. So you see all these like pinnacles of wow, AI does all this stuff. And that really expands your view. We keep having these like forces in here that kind of push us out from the center. You have all of these forces telling you, wow, AI can do amazing things. But every once in a while, you fall into one of these like holes almost. You fall into these like spaces between these other amazing capabilities. And when we fall into these spaces, that's where there's a misconception. Because we see these amazing things, right? We assume that all of these gaps in the middle are filled. We assume that like AI capability has like grown and grown to encompass everything. But the reality is that AI capability has these points, right? It hasn't expanded. It hasn't productized. It hasn't become this very efficient and useful tool the way that like Excel has become useful. It's not that same tool. It really doesn't have that capability today. And so we really expect that there aren't gaps. We have this phrasing that tells us like it's changing everything. You almost have to believe that in a way. And so I of course have struggled with this. I actually wrote a blog post a little while ago called The Fear of Missing AI, where I talk about like how quick things are changing, but I've got a new take on it and a new approach to thinking about it. And these are just three steps to avoid the hype. The first step is really just to like ground yourself. Ask how and like why something works. So you see this amazing capability, you see this incredible tool. Look at like why it works. Read about how these technologies have been developed. Read studies and surveys and the different things people are like trying with. Read about how people have tried and failed on certain experiments. Once you start looking at how these tools work, you can start to see how they might be simple in a way. They aren't this like complex, very capable tool. They may actually have like limitations. You see that very easily with AI tools, right? AIs would often do like crazy stuff with fingers where they suddenly like get a big mishmash of a bunch of different hands and things together where you're generating these hands, but they don't actually line up with anything. In manufacturing, there's this idea of Six Sigma, which is like things work 99.69% of the time. When you produce something, you have a failure rate or an error rate that's like that small. AI doesn't have that, even remotely close. We don't necessarily need that to work. There's plenty of things in the world that we use that don't have that degree of like certainty, but ground yourself in that, right? We know that it maybe wouldn't be the best thing for those types of problems. What problems could it solve? Step two is really, I'm an innovator, so this is like how I think, but I think building something is really an amazing way of thinking about this stuff. If you haven't actually used AI for a project, or if you haven't talked to somebody who's familiar with AI in a very deep way, like try interviewing like one of your friends or somebody, put that into a piece of writing, put it on a blog, or just put it in your journal. Create something, right? Maybe that's even better here. Rather than build something, let's do create something. Because you don't need to build an app, but you need to engage with this in a more than passive way. If everyone's being passive, you're going to believe whatever somebody tells you. I do a lot of coding with AI, and there are a lot of times where I have problems that AI can't help me with. That may be because I'm terrible at prompting. That could totally be. But when I even ask general questions, sometimes it has a difficult time understanding what I mean. These tools are generally helpful, but specifically helpless. And there are ways of building specific tools to help with a specific need. And I think creating something helps you understand like the depth of this space, the depth of what these AIs, these LLMs, these different tools can do for you. I have this idea of a world that I want to build. And I've described this to Midjourney so many times. I've described it to Dolly. I've described it to all these different things. I've put in images that looked right. And I haven't gotten something that actually fit my mental image of this. There are still a range of things that like these AI art applications aren't even able to cover. When you actually try and create what you had in your head and what you had in mind, you'll note that there's a significant gap. And you really can only find that by creating something. I spent a lot of time creating this tool that I'm excited about called Stable Canvas. It's a tool where I can iterate on an idea. So here I was thinking about frontiers in space, or frontiers that are based on land. And I created a bunch of different images based on that, and you riff off of it. So you create a first image, create a second image, tweak it a little bit. Okay, now I'm like video game. Now it's a video game that's a shooter. But you can keep this going. I think that the way that we work with AI tools is wrong. I'm seeing something unique in that space. And that's really my like third point, which is like tinker with cool stuff. Find things that you can do with these tools that nobody else has really thought of or nobody else is really talking about. Find cool things in your domain, in the work that you do or the things that you're interested in that nobody else has even tried. One of the tools that I really love is like Obsidian. I use it for like note taking and keeping track of things. It's got these amazing notes that kind of connect in these kind of node networks. With that, I use this tool called Obsidian Smart Connections, and I pull an AI into my notes so that I can actually like converse with it. There's a lot of applications out there, but I love that Obsidian is based on these like raw text files that you own that are on your computer. And I'm just able to pull in like a plugin to like play with that. And I can control how that plugin acts with my data. That tells me a lot about, okay, where are the limitations to like open tools like this? What could be improved about that space? Another place that I really like playing in right now is using these tools like LM Studio. You can run like a variety of LLMs on your own machine using your own hardware. And this is like a really awesome tool for being able to see how much range there is in the different LLMs that are available to you. I've tried a number of these and it's been really eye-opening to me just how much more I know about how OpenAI has trained their models. So tinker with stuff, tinker with cool stuff. This is my like general advice to you. Ground yourself in the reality of the world, in the research that you've done, in what you've seen, in what you've looked up, in the understanding that you've gained about LLMs. Create something, build something with that. It could be something simple that's for yourself. It could be something that you share with a lot of your friends or that you post online. Whatever it is, just try creating something with AI. And I think that'll really help damper how much hype you feel. And finally, just start tinkering with stuff. Start playing with different tools and see what's possible. Don't feel that like overwhelming pressure. Remember that we all think that AI is this like incredible, all-encompassing thing. But the reality is it does a few key things and it's going to be a long time before it does everything really well. don't get obsessed with the hype, ground yourself, and just start making some progress, I think you'll feel a lot better. I certainly do. If you've enjoyed this and you want to learn more about AIs, LLMs, or just how we perceive the future here on Stable Discussion, you can look at our blog. We've got a lot of different writing there, including some different projects that we're working on, like Stable Canvas, which you can learn about and read more here. We're going to be creating more content here that's aimed at this somewhat technical audience. We're focused on educating and making sure that everyone understands what these AI tools are capable of and really enabling you for your future. Thanks so much. Catch you next time.